Welcome to the second edition of The Story Unfolds, Southern Rail Off the Rails. This time last week, we're at the Southern Justice protest speaking to the demonstrators, but a lot can happen in a week.
In an attempt to stop the organised 14 days of protest over the dispute about onboard supervisors, Monday the 3rd of October saw Southern Rail put forth an ultimatum to the RMT, stating they had until midday Thursday to accept or risk the termination of contracts. The proposal would see a lump sum of £2,000 paid to all conductors and a guarantee on jobs until 2021. The Southern Justice crowdfunding campaign ended Wednesday, raising well over their £25,000 target, but we'll have more on that next week.
So this week, I'll be speaking to people from the RMT Union, so I'll come down to where they hang out. We'll start this off, obviously today there was an ultimatum. What kind of went down at the talks?
We made an offer to the company to try and reach a settlement, a genuine offer. We offered them to call off all industrial action, but of course we did have to say that they would guarantee a guard every train where there's a current requirement for them. That was the major stumbling block.
Paul and Gary are insisting that the planned proposals would see a drop in safety.
It's not about money or asking for less hours and more days off and better conditions. None of it's ever been about that.
I mean, so yeah. You know, you say one of the hardest challenges is actually getting across to the public, you know, your issues. In some ways, do you feel like you're fighting a PR war?
The employers turned it into a PR war. Now, we know that they've employed an external PR company, have played this PR exercise that it's all about who pushes a button to close the door.
So with no agreement reached, the strikes will go ahead as planned, but it's yet to be seen whether the Southern Rail threat to terminate contracts will come into fruition.
What's in the future for you guys?
We are always available to talk because of the way the company are responding is they've got no other option but to withdraw the labour. They've withdrawn the labour to make it medium and long term safe railway system for the passengers, for the students, for the elderly, and it's not driven just by large profits at the expense of safety on the railways, because that's a step backwards.
So there we have it, the RMT Union. To keep up with the story, tune in next week on The Story Unfolds.